Can you define dry? Dry, don't repeat yourself, that promotes the concept of reusing the code. This results in developing and sharing the libraries, which in turn result in tight coupling. Can you define Eureka? Eureka is the Netflix service discovery server and client. Eureka server is using Spring Cloud. Can you explain Spring Cloud? Spring Cloud Stream App Starters are Spring Boot-based Spring integration applications that provide integration with external systems. Spring Cloud Task, a short-lived microservices framework to quickly build applications that perform finite amounts of data processing. Can you define CQRS? CQRS, Command and Query Responsibility Segregation, is a pattern that segregates the operations that read data, queries, from the operations that update data, commands, by using separate interfaces. This means that the data models used for querying and updates are different. Or CQRS is simply the query was previously only one. The separation occurs based upon whether the methods are a command or a query. Can you define Conway's Law? Any different organization that designs a system, defined broadly, will produce a design whose structure is a copy of the organization's communication structure. Can you define Service Registry? The Service Registry is a database populated with information on how to dispatch requests to microservice instances. A service registry needs to be highly available and up-to-date. Clients can cache network locations obtained from the service registry. How do you set up service discovery? Spring Cloud supports several ways to implement service discovery, but for this I am going to use Eureka created by Netflix. Spring Cloud provides several annotations to make it use easy and hiding lots of complexity. Can you explain continuous monitoring? CM, continuous monitoring, gets into the depth of monitoring coverage, from in-browser front-end performance metrics, through application performance, and down to host virtualized infrastructure metrics. Can you explain semantic monitoring? Semantic monitoring is also known as synthetic monitoring. It combines automated tests with monitoring the application, web application or mobile application, in order to detect business falling factors. Can you explain continuous integration? Continuous integration, process of automating the build and testing of code every time a team member commits changes to version control. This encourages developers to share code and unit tests by merging the changes into a shared version control repository after every small task completion. Can you explain DDD? DDD stands for domain-driven design. An interesting software design technique to understand and solve complexity is DDD. It provides an avenue to facilitate the development of highly cohesive systems through bounded contexts. Model services based on domain-driven design. Microservices is an implementation approach that encourages you to focus why our service boundaries on the business domain boundaries. DDD and microservices can be used together as you move your organization to a service-oriented design and reap the benefits of continuous integration. What is contract testing? Contract testing is writing tests to ensure that the explicit and implicit contract of a microservice works as advertised. There are two perspectives when it comes to contract tests, consumer and provider. Contract testing is immediately applicable anywhere where you have two services that need to communicate, such as an API client and a web front end. Can you define PACT? PACT is a contract testing tool. PACT is an open source CDC testing framework. It also provides a wide range of language supports like Ruby, Java, Scala, .NET Framework, JavaScript, Swift/Objective-C. We will go through the two major steps with code examples. Can you explain canary releasing? It is a technique to reduce the risk of introducing a new software version in production. This is done by slowly rolling out the change to a small subset of users before giving it out to the entire infrastructure, i.e. making it available to everybody. Can you explain cross-functional testing? Cross-functional testing is a verification of non-functional requirements, those requirements which cannot be implemented like a normal feature. Can you explain cross-browser testing? Cross-browser testing is simply what its name means, that is, to test your website or application in multiple browsers and making sure that it works consistently and as intended without any dependencies or compromise in quality. This testing is applicable to both web and mobile apps. Can you explain component testing? Component testing is also known as program testing or module testing, is done after unit testing. In this type of testing, those test objects can be tested independently as a component without integrating with other components for example modules, classes, objects, and programs. This testing is done by the development team. What is the importance of web, RESTful APIs? A microservice architecture is based on a concept wherein all its services should be able to interact with each other to build a business functionality. So, to achieve this, each microservice must have an interface. This makes the web API a very important enabler of microservices. Being based on the open networking principles of the web, RESTful APIs provide the most logical model for building interfaces between the various components of microservice architecture. How do you access a RESTful microservice? Load balanced REST template. If there are multiple REST template, you get the right one. It can use to access multiple microservices. Can you explain service discovery in microservice architecture? Service discovery is about finding the network location of a service provider. There are two types of service discovery patterns. Client-side discovery pattern, the client is responsible for determining the network locations of available service instances and load balancing requests across them. The client queries a service registry, which is a database of available service instances. The client then uses them to select one of the available service instances and makes a request. Server-side discovery pattern, consumer send requests to a load balancer, the load balancer query from registry and decide which location of providers to send to. Can you explain shed light on Tasklet with reference to Spring Batch and microservices? It is important to note that Spring Batch easily provides a Tasklet interface with the help of which the application can perform a single task. It can also clean and delete the various types of resources that are needed before the final execution step. Which companies are using microservices? Amazon.com, Netflix, eBay, Twitter, Uber, Nordstrom, The Guardian, Gill. What are the cons of microservices? Difficult to achieve strong consistency across services. ACID transactions do not span multiple processes. Distributed system so hard to debug and trace the issues. Greater need for end-to-end testing. Required cultural changes in across teams like dev and ops working together even in same team. Developers have to put additional effort into implementing the mechanism of communication between the services. Handling use cases that span more than one service without using distributed transactions is not only tough but also requires communication and cooperation between different teams. The architecture usually results in increased memory consumption. Partitioning the application into microservices is.
Like, share, and comment. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. Click the bell button for latest updates.